Okay, Griswold 811S ANSI pump. We're going to be showing you how to install a AES cartridge seal. I'll let Wayne take it from here.
All right. Take our stuffing box, put all our studs in, which has already been done for us, and take our seal, and with the flush line facing towards the sight glass, the power frame, which we want to install that onto the stuffing box. Then we take our washers. We like to put two per post for strength. Put our nuts down out. Cartridge seal comes with these plastic plugs. We normally would put a stainless quarter inch plug in it, but for purposes we don't need to do that right now. So once you get that in, you want to lube that back O-ring. It's going to seal on the sleeve, a little bit of lube. We take our sleeve, put it on the shaft of our power frame. Take our stuffing box and seal, flush line facing towards the sight glass. Straight on. Put our nuts on for the stuffing box. We need some glue on the thread of the shaft. Feller, so it holds in that O-ring in there. Put it on. Crank it up. Okay, once that's on, put our case back on. I like putting our case basket inside the case. A little easier to slide on that way. Case bolts. Make sure that these impeller adjusting bolts are backed off so we put our case on and start bumping up against that impeller. And tighten down our case. Okay, now we have to adjust. Set the impeller. First, I run it all the way forward. That'll be our starting point. Okay. dial indicator to zero. Back it out to 20,000. Back to 15,000 for our desired setting. And put the jam nuts. Okay, once you've got that set, put this aside, then you can go back to your seal. You notice I kept it loose so that the shaft and impeller can slide back and forth so we can get our setting. So now we've got our setting, we can tighten up the seal. Do a little bit on both sides to make sure the seal goes in straight and flat. You won't have a leak. Then there's set screws, you run those in and that'll mate up to the shaft. Once you get those tightened up enough, you can take out the safety clips. These clips you want to save in case you ever have to make any kind of adjustment. Put those back on. Okay, there's your seal.